The World of Reading Poem by me. Okay. I walked in my room and sat in my chair. I put on a small cloak and fixed my hair. From my bookshelf, so thick and full, I pull out a book to jump into. The Hobbit is what I pulled out, and guess what? Thank God it's the one I'm most fond of out of them all. I get comfy and think about when I read, the people I'll meet and the places I'll see. I think what I'm gonna read in this book, I imagine about reading about a pig that can cook and a penguin that can fly up so high in the sky that people need to lay down to see how high it can fly. I read a few pages I'm already in as I fly away on a magical carpet away towards a new world that's about to begin. I'm done with the first chapter and I already feel unbelievably breathtaking, inspired, surprised, and enormously outstanding. As I read more words, something's pulling me in, deeper and deeper so far in. No one can save me now, for I wish not to be saved from this realm of books where I wish not to be saved. I see my friends and some family too, who also wander in this realm. Not shocked at all, I see my teacher who we call Mr. B too. He's sitting in a tree way up high, being careful not to fall as he waves and says hi. Then back he goes into his book while saying goodbye as I fall back in the realm again too. I think about those who never see this realm of stories and how sad those people might be. For I wish everyone could be in this world where we can believe and be here for as long as this majestic world lets us be. For those of us who've been deep and far in this world, you all know who you are. I know that those of us who are deep and far never want to leave. No, 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 not at all. But sadly, we must all leave this realm and go back to where the magic leaves us far behind. If you leave, don't be sad. Just pick up a book to jump back. Get comfy and put on a cloak, then fix your hair, for adventures lie ahead. Beware. I'm stuck in this realm, giving you all this advice that I don't even realize it's 5:15. It's 5:15 and I don't even realize my mom's standing near, watching me stare off into nowhere. I stare at the clock, pondering who I've met and where. I snap out, then hear my mom asking me, are you coming to eat or should this food go to waste? I'm sucked back into my days for a while. Then I wonder whether this was a dream. Then I smile. I smile since they say that your dream is your future. So if this is my future, then I know that I'm going back to the world I wish to be in. I now know that everyone can go to the place I love, just if they read and believe.